I'm Simon Gardner, Farms Director of Varfell Farms, relief demonstration farm based in West Cornwall. We're farming 1,800 hectares, predominantly of daffodils for the cut flower market, supplying multiple retailers in UK and Europe. But we also include brassicas, cereals and potatoes within our farm rotation.
I'm Joe Oliver, I'm the Catchment Sensitive Farming Advisor for West Cornwall and the Fowl. We're here in the Marazion catchment, and the concern with the catchment is runoff affecting Marazion Marsh, which is a special protection area and a site of special scientific interest. Marazion Marsh is an important wetland site with reed bed, willow car and open water, and this is important for a variety of wetland birds, including the overwintering bittern and the aquatic warbler, and it's also important for its dragonfly populations. Water quality issues in the Marazion catchment predominantly result from agriculture and include sediment and nutrient runoff, which is due to high rainfall during the winter months and poor soil structure, compaction and erosion. As a result, Marazion Marsh is at risk from excessive sediment and phosphate runoff and nitrate leaching.
When we came here farming 5 years ago, we were looking at a rotation that didn't really work. I was seeing a lot of brown water run out of fields. We're in short rotations, heavily cropped, and we were seeing yields decline. So it was important to me that we reversed that trend, started to look at building yield and how we do that. So that's why soils was the real priority. It's the fundamental of any growing system, and getting that right and in tip one condition is really important. Someone once told me the most important day of a crop's life is the day you plant it, and the second most important is the day before. Historically, the first year of a daffodil crop, which this is, the crop's in for 5 years, would be brown soil. It would be loose soil, having recently been planted in the summer previous, and hugely prone to soil erosion. So a daffodil's planted in August, September, and then doesn't come out of the ground until November, December, January, depending on the variety. And in that time, you've got heavy rainfalls, and soils are really prone, particularly when they're heavily tilled like a daffodil is, to sliding down the hill. So what we've done here is we've created a soil that's got green cover all over it. Here we're using grass and the natural floor of the local weeds to hold that soil in place. When the daffodil hasn't come up yet, it's given the microorganisms in the soil something to feed on. It's maintaining the structure as the roots crack open and hold any capped soil in place. It's stopping soil structures from compacting. It's allowing the water to go down into the soils, but not flow across the field. And it's really important. We've just come out of a really hot, dry summer. These green covers are capturing that water, banking it in the earth, so we're having less of an issue with droughts, but also seeing less soil erosion at the same time. We've got a 10-year rotation, so the first 5 years are daffodils. So that means the field's been cultivated once in 5 years for the crop. Following the daffodils, we're growing potatoes. Then we've got a cereal, a brassica, a cereal and a brassica for the remaining years of the rotation. During that time, we're using minimum till or direct drilling. So when we're cultivating the grounds to put the daffodil into the soil, we're using minimum tillage, we're no longer ploughing. That's allowing us to remove compaction from the soil, but it's also firming the soil up and giving a consolidated seed bed with a packer roll at the back, so reducing the risk of erosion. The cereals are all direct drilled, so they're direct drilled into a cover crop. That's a multi-species cover crop of phacelia, vetch and buckwheat. And direct drilling into there means that we're not cultivating the soil, we're not releasing that carbon, we're not damaging the soil structures that the cover crop has created for us. We've implemented grass tracks all around our fields to allow us to get the flowers in and out. When I first moved here, these were mud tracks and they were super highways for soil erosion. But simply putting them down to grass has reduced the erosion. It's actually made it a lot easier to get tractors and trailers in and out the fields. And we also cause less damage in the local community, so we're not dragging mud out onto the roads in quite the volume that we were. So we're protecting our fields, looking after the community, and it's easier on machinery. And during the winter months, they're really prone to erosion. So we plant barley at the same time as we're planting the daffodil bulbs. The barley is very quick to establish. It grows quickly, putting roots down and foliage above the ground. This holds the soil in place, but also stops the water flowing down. So it's made a real big difference to soil erosion that we used to see.
Cover crops keep soils held together and provides soil cover over the winter months, so that sediments and nutrients are less likely to wash away during heavy rainfall. The choice of cover crops is dependent on growers' preferences for their particular situation. The choices of cover crops can be dependent on farming practices, arable rotation, and soil type. Deeper rooting cover crops such as tiller radish can help break up soil compaction. Nitrogen is also taken up by winter cover crops rather than being leached through the soil on bare ground. There are a wide range of cover crop species available, such as phacelia, buckwheat and chicory, which all have specific benefits and can be useful in different circumstances.
So while we're very unique at Varfell as being a flower business, a lot of what we're doing is very simple. It's very easy to implement. It can be implemented in multiple situations and it's not necessarily unique to flower growing. So anywhere that you've got risk of water erosion or soil erosion, barley can be used. Anywhere where you've got wet headlands or land that's not suitable for cropping, grass is fantastic to put in those places. And it really protects the environment that we're working in. It captures water, it stops runoff, it stops soil erosion. You know, vital that we do these as farmers and protect the land that we're custodians of.
Catchment Sensitive Farming is working in the Marazion catchment to provide support and advice to growers with the challenges they face. We can offer specialist farm advice and financial support through countryside stewardship. This can help to reduce the risk of sediment and phosphate runoff, as well as nitrate leaching. It also highlights the importance of compliance with farming rules for water. For further advice, please visit Catchment Sensitive Farming, advice for farmers and land managers on .gov.uk.